evening to all for this wonderful gathering for the program Right Pitch to the Right Audience in the web series of four with the topic of telecommunication network management. So this topic has been specifically designed to know how the curriculum to be faced by the students, especially for the forthcoming sessions, to give a good platform, because platform is very important, especially for the professional students once they have been taking different kinds of analytical as well as the theoretical subjects. So this Right Pitch to the Right Audience is giving the right platform to the students in what way the basics is very needed, especially once they are going for the different kinds of projects and different kinds of social related environment to be created. So in today's speaker, I welcome Mr. Sagitya Piridashini and Mr. Kartika to take over the session.
Thank you, sir. The value of an idea lies in the using of it. As the words say, we are here for the program. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Right Pitch to the Right Audience, Strengths in Network Management, a web series 4. Let me introduce myself. I'm Sahitya Priyadeshni, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE. Along with me, I have my colleague, Mrs. D. Kartika, for presenting the session. I would like to take this opportunity to talk to you about trends in network management. The purpose of this presentation is to have a general outline about telecommunication network management. Here we have objectives, what, when, where, how we are using telecommunication network management. All the real-time network providers are running with the help of telecommunication network management. Example, mobile services, the DTH in our homes, remote monitoring system, and so on. Before knowing about telecommunication network management, I'd like to give you some background information about what is network, network management, telecommunication, then to the frame of telecommunication network management. First of all, what is network? In general, it is a system of lines, wire that are connected to each other. Or we can define a network as a system of computers and other devices that are connected to each other. Or I can say like this also, a group of people or organizations that are closely connected and working and work with each other. From all the definitions, in technically we can say a network consists of multiple devices that communicate with one another. It can be as small as two computers or as large as billions of devices. Different computer systems that are communicated by a physical or a wireless means. It may be a LAN connection or maybe a WAN connection. Then what is a LAN connection? What is in LAN? A local area network is a collection of devices connected together in one physical location, such as a building, office, or home. A LAN may be a small or large, ranging from a home network within one user to an enterprise network with thousands of users and the device in an office or school. A LAN may comprises of cables, access points, switches, routers, and other components that enable devices to connect to internal servers, web servers, and other LANs via a wide area network. For example, in an office with multiples of departments such as accounting, IT support, and administration, each department's computers could be logically connected to the same switch but segment. So coming to WAN, A WAN is a wide area network. It's a collection of local networks and other networks that communicate with one another. A WAN is essentially a network of networks. Today, there are several types of WANs built for varieties of use cases that touch virtually every aspect of modern life. Internet connection is an example for WAN. Other example of a WAN are mobile broadband connection such as 3G, 4G, etc. Moving to what is network management, it is the process of administrating and managing computer networks. It is a discipline include fault analysis, performance analysis, provisioning of networks, monitoring, reporting, observing, controlling, and maintaining the quality of services. The network management services provide complete support for the management and support process for local area networks and wide area network. Service provider either on site or remotely. The world will stop without this word. It's nothing but telecommunication. Telecommunication, the exchange of information in any form, voice, maybe data, text, image, audio, video, over a network is said to be telecommunication. Example, your mobile network, we have many applications that has been running in your mobile. We can take an example app as WhatsApp, where we are sending voice message, data, text, images, audio, video. So we can take mobile network as an example for your telecommunication. Then what is the working principle of your telecommunication? Telecommunication is a sending of information in any form from our place to another using electronics or light emitting media. The basic components of telecommunications are terminal, telecommunication processor, telecommunication channel, computer, telecommunication software. Terminal. Terminal is an input or output device that uses telecommunication network to transmit or receive data. That is terminal. Telecommunication processor. It supports data transmission and reception between terminals and computer. For example, we can say modem, switches, routers. Next, coming to telecommunication channels. Telecommunication channels are the media over which data are transmitted and received. Computers. So computers of all size and type of computers are interconnected by telecommunication network so that they can carry their information processing assignments. Last, telecommunication software. It consists of programs that control telecommunication activities and manage the functions of telecommunication network. So overall, together, terminal, telecommunication processor, telecommunication channel, computer, telecommunication software will frame you telecommunication network model. The telecommunication network management is the next thing. So what is telecommunication network management? It is a framework for achieving interconnectivity and communication across heterogeneous operating system and telecommunication networks. It's nothing but heterogeneous or interconnectivity between heterogeneous operating system and telecommunication network. Telecommunication network management was developed by International Telecommunication Unit, ITU, as an infrastructure to support management and deployment of telecommunication services. So what is the main framework of telecommunication management? The main principles are incorporated into telecommunication network to send and receive information and to manage its resources. A telecommunication network is comprised of switching systems, circuit, terminals. In telecommunication technology, the resources are referred as network elements. The telecommunication network enables communication between operations, support system, and network elements. A telecommunication architecture and infrastructure defined in ITU. ITU is nothing but your information international telecommunication unit, which I recommend the model M3 series built on existing open system interconnectivity standard, that is on your OSI standard. These standards include, but they are not to the limit. What are the standards they include is CMIP, Common Management Information Protocol, which defines management services exchanged between the peer entities. Next, guideline for defining of managed objects. Here we are going to have managed object providing template for classifying and describing managed resources. Abstract syntax notation 1 that provides syntax rules for data type. Open system interconnectivity reference model defines the 7 layers of your OSI reference model. All this together will frame you what is telecommunication network framework. Next, we move on to network management standards. So here we have already familiar standards like OSI model, SNMP, TNM, IEEE. So we'll have a short information about all these standards. So OSI, Open System Interconnection, it is an international standard. It manages data communication network. It deals with all 7 layers and its object-oriented system. SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol, it is an industrial standard. It is easy to implement and most widely implemented protocol. It is based on Internet Management Network. It is adopted by telecommunication network and WAN networks. Third, network management, telecommunication network management. It is an international standard used to manage of telecommunication network. It is built on OSI network management framework. It addresses both network and administrative aspects of management. Last standard is your IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. It is an international standard. It addresses both LAN and MAN connection. It also adopts OSI standard. In the OSI standard, it deals with the first 2 layers. So all these 4 standards will combine together to form you in working principles of telecommunication network management. So till now, we have seen about a light introduction about what is telecommunication, and other information will be shared by Mrs. Kartika. Kartika ma'am, please ma'am.
Thank you ma'am. Ma'am, my screen is visible, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, your screen is visible.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable speech, ma'am. So I'm Mrs. Kartika, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE. Ma'am has already told you about networks, telecommunication, and its framework. Now I am going to discuss about different protocols that help you to communicate over different networks. So first, what is protocol? Network protocols are set of rules, conventions, and data structures that tells how device exchange data across networks. So there are several types of protocols available in networks. There are SNMP, TCP, IP, HTTP, SMTP, FTP, POP, UDP. So let's we see in detail. So first one, SNMP. So abbreviation for this SNMP is Simple Network Management Protocol. It is an application layer protocol which is used to monitor and manage the network devices and local area as well as wide area networks. So the main purpose of SNMP is it will provide network devices with a common language for sharing information with a network management system. Here, network devices represent routers, servers, and printers. So next protocol is TCP. So the full abbreviation for TCP is Transmission Control Protocol. So TCP is popular communication protocol and which is used for communication over a network. This protocol is divide the message into series of packets. These packets are sent from source to destination and finally it get reassembled in destination, right? It may happens in transport layer. So next protocol is IP, which means internet protocol. So internet protocol designed for addressing protocol. It is mostly used with TCP. So TCP IP is the most popular protocol connecting the network. Next protocol is HTTP. So the abbreviation for the HTTP is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. This protocol is mainly designed for transferring a hypertext among two or more systems. Next protocol is SMTP. The abbreviation for SMTP is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. This protocol is designed to send and distribute outgoing emails. Next one, FTP, File Transfer Protocol. This protocol allows user to transfer files from one machine to another machine. Here the files like program files or multimedia files or text files or document, any files can be sent from one machine to another machine by using this FTP. And next, POP, Post Office Protocol. This protocol is designed for receiving incoming emails. And final, UDP, User Datagram Protocol. This protocol is substitute communication protocol to transmission control protocol. This protocol is designed for creating loss tolerating and low latency linking between applications. In telecommunication network management, we are only focusing one main protocol, that is SNMP. Let me discuss detail about SNMP. Simple Network Management Protocol. What is SNMP? How it works? Why we need to choose this SNMP protocol? First, what is SNMP? So the formal definition for SNMP is exchanging information between network devices. So network devices are, it may be routers or switches or hubs or computers or laptop. So these are all the network devices. Let us consider one example. Consider you are having 1,000 or 10,000 of routers, switches in your network environment. You need to monitor all of those devices. In this case, monitoring the device manually is not possible, right? Here, SNMP plays the major role. It will monitor and manage the networks. How the SNMP works? There are two main elements available in SNMP. So first one, SNMP manager, and second one, SNMP agent. What is the role of SNMP manager? The place where the software tools running to monitor the devices is called SNMP manager. What is the role of SNMP agent? Agents are nothing but the networking devices like routers, switches. So which is used to collect data about disk, bandwidth usages, and other network performance metrics can be measured and collected by this SNMP agent. So this is the SNMP architecture. What is the role of SNMP manager? It has some key features like querying agents, which means each device on the network has some agents installed on it, and communication of SNMP takes place between the manager and the system management agents. After querying the agents, it gets the response from agents. Then set variables in agent. Finally, it provides acknowledgement from the agent. So next, what is the role of SNMP? It also has some key features like collect management information about its local environment and store and retrieve the managed information from the database and store the information into the database for future usage. Sometimes this agent acts as proxy for some non-SNMP manageable network nodes. So what is set or get command? So what is the use of this? It is generated by the SNMP manager and sent to agent to obtain the value of variable. After getting the request, agent will produce the response. So response is sent by the agent to manager. It contains values of requested variables. The request is also called as PDUs. PDU is nothing but protocol data unit. It also called as get request. And trap messages. So trap means notification messages. Like when the error or failure has occurred in the network, it will show some error message to the SNMP manager. That message is called as trap messages. In figure, it will retrieve the request from the SNMP manager and agent reply for that request. SNMP has three versions. First one, SNMP version 1, SNMP version 2, and SNMP version 3. In SNMP version 1, it used for community strings for authentication, but it uses only in UDP. In version 2, it also uses community strings for authentication, but it uses both UDP and TCP. Next, SNMP version 3, when compared to other version, this will provide more secure. So SNMP version 1 and version 2 also provide security. When compared to these two version, SNMP 3 provide more and more security. It will store the data very confidentially. When the admin wants to share the information, then only messages can be viewed. Otherwise, it will be secured. Another aspects of network management is network monitoring. That is monitoring an entire network as opposed to individual routers, hosts, and other devices. Remote monitoring and management was developed to help us understand how the network itself is running or functioning, as well as how individual devices on the network are affecting the network as a whole. What is the difference between SNMP and remote monitoring tool? So SNMP tracks basic health metrics. Basic health metrics means performance, like in the network devices, and it facilitates necessary configuration changes. But remote monitoring tool, it is an extension of SNMP. It provides traffic flow data for troubleshooting and control the necessary to adjust for better performance from a central console. Why we should monitor network performance? Let us consider one example. Usually networks are the backbone of every business. Even if the business is small or world level, the network are the backbone. If the productivity is lost during network outage, which affect the business in huge manner, if we are using network monitoring tool, means we will help you anticipate potential outages and proactively address the network problem, which means we can previously know the network issues so that we can maintain congestion free network and keep our business up and running good or normal flow, right? So that we are using the network performance tool. So network monitoring tool, remote monitoring tool is the best example for network monitoring tool. How the remote monitoring tool is working? Remote monitoring tool works based on remote monitoring props or remote monitoring agents. It may be hardware or software or software embedded network. This prop software usually runs on the port of the network devices, so that we can capture information, capture the traffic activity, and we can provide the statistics of network protocols. This will be saved for future use. When the error is occurred or failure in the network, we can refer the saved information so that the congestion free network is we can provide. Main advantage of using this remote monitoring is network administrator can monitor networks, save logs, capture historical performance, and get notified in case of any issues. There are two specifications available in remote monitoring. So remote monitoring 1 and remote monitoring 2. This is the example for remote monitoring tool. So how the remote monitoring tool is working? By two procedures it will be worked. First, that measure or detect common physiological parameters like health, temperature, pulse rate, and SpO2 of a particular patient that can be measured. And second, this information transmit to the particular healthcare provider or monitoring entity. How the remote monitoring tool is working means a remote patient health monitoring system that can be installed at home or hospitals to handle isolated COVID-19 cases. The main aim is to reduce the risk of exposure in healthcare workers. It also reduces the increasing demand of PPE. So PPE means personal protection equipment. In AIIMS Hospital in Rishikesh, this remote monitoring tool is installed so that the health monitoring worker can monitor the access the complaints of the patient. If found necessary, they will provide the patient health monitoring kit to his or her parameter regularly. Patient location are uploaded on a regular basis on a centralized command or control center on a cloud using either the patient mobile number or GSM SIM card. Based on this threshold, an alert is sent to medical officer and healthcare workers. It will also show the severity of the patient condition using color codes. With this, I conclude my talk on trend in network management. On behalf of Mrs. Sagitya ma'am and myself, I thank the management, registrar sir, principal sir, and HOD sir for giving this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
So I take this opportunity to thank both the speakers, Mr. Sagitya Piridarshini, Assistant Professor of Department of Computer Science and Engineering, and Mrs. Kartika, an Assistant Professor of Department of Computer Science Engineering, to give the presence of how the telecommunication network system to be monitored. So one thing I want to make focus on this particular topic, especially for the forthcoming students to be carried out this particular subject. So this subject will be mainly carried out about the networks monitoring tools. So you see, for example, if you take about the network, we will take it in two aspects. One is physical architecture as well as in logical architecture, actually. So this telecommunication network management system will be focused on logical architecture, which mean about how the network performance will be maintained, how the network testings will be concluded. So all this kind of analyzation and as well as the architecture designing methods will be taken in this particular subject. So this will be useful to be merged with the computer network. So I think the right subjects to be handled with the both aspects. So students should understand in two aspects: that network, you are understanding the normal the computer networks you are studying with the name of physical structure, how the topology construction is being made, how the WAN construction is being made. So like that, it being taken about that particular one. Telecommunication network management will call about the logical architectures, will take about the performance to be related to the network which has been designed actually. So that is what the platform, the basic platform which is given by the two speakers on today's session. So I thank the students to be gathered over here on the presence. And we will shortly meet on Web Series 5 tomorrow. Thank you.